Hello everyone, welcome to See and Learn. Today we will continue to the second part of important terms in computer programming. Those who have not watched the part 1, please watch it. The link is given in the description box. So we will discuss some terms in this lecture. Some terms are related with program types of languages like machine language, assembly language, high level language, and some terms related to the computer programs or softwares that are used for execution of program like preprocessor, assembler, compiler, interpreter, linker and loader. So the first term we are going to discuss is machine language. Machine language is also known as machine code. Machine language is a lowest level programming language and consists of binary digits or bits, that means zeros and ones. These are read by the computers. It is the only language understood by computers. It consists of only numbers, and these numbers are not understood by humans. So programmers write the code in high level languages, and this high level language code is then translated into the assembly language or machine language by a compiler, which is then converted to the machine language by an assembler. Now we will move to the next term, assembly language. An assembly language is low level programming language. This language is used for microprocessor or other programmable devices. This language uses mnemonics or codes. For example, 8085, 8086 uses the assembly language programming. The next term is high level language. High level language is programming language that lets the programmer to write the programs. For example, C, C++, Java, these all are the high level languages. Now we will move to the next terms. These terms are related to the computer programs or softwares that are used for program execution. The first term is preprocessor. So preprocessor is a program or software that runs before the compiler. It reads all the statements, starts with the hash and expands the code. It also removes the comments in the program. It is called as preprocessor as it preprocesses the program. The second term is assembler. As we know that a computer don't understand any program written in a programming language other than the machine language. So programs must be translated into the machine language. Such translation is performed with the help of a software, and the software which translates an assembly language program into a machine language program is called an assembler. Now we will see what is meant by compiler. It is a program which translates high level language program into machine language program. It translates whole program at a time. A compiler is more intelligent than an assembler because it checks all kinds of error also. The next type of program is interpreter. An interpreter is a program which translates the statements of a program into machine code. It translates only one statement of a program at a time. It reads only one statement of a program, translate it and execute it. Then go for the next statement, read it, translate it and execute it. Now, what is the difference between the compiler and interpreter? Actually, compiler and interpreter do the same job, that converts the high level language to the machine code. But compiler is faster than interpreter. Again, compiler convert the code into machine code before program run, and interpreter converts code into machine code when program is run. Now we will see what is meant by linker. In high level languages, some built-in header files or library files are stored. These libraries are predefined, and this contains basic functions which are essential for execution of the program. We will see these files in programming. These functions are linked to the libraries by the program, and this program is called as the linker. If linker does not find the library of a function, then it informs the compiler and compiler generates the error. So linking is the main task of the linker. It links the functions with the libraries. The second task of linker is it also links the user defined functions to the user defined libraries. That means, like library functions, it also links the user defined functions to the user defined libraries. The third job of linker is usually a longer program is divided into smaller or sub programs called as modules, and these modules must be combined to execute a program. So this process of combining the modules is done by the linker. So this is the third job of the linker. Now we will see what is meant by loader. Loader is a program that loads machine code of a program into the system memory. That means it is responsible for loading program. So what it does? This involves reading the content of executable file into memory, and after loading is complete, the program starts. So these are all the terms that are related with types of languages and types of programs used for execution. So that's it for today. Hope you would like the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel. Click the bell icon for more updates. See you soon in the next video. Until then, stay tuned, stay blessed.